Humans experience the physical world through multiple senses, but the brain only understands electrical signals. Therefore, there has to be some method for our cells within the body to convert external stimuli from our senses into electrical ones that our brain can understand. This type of signal conversion is called signal or sensory transduction, and it is one of the most important processes used by the brain to understand the outside world. I'm Colin Fosnot, and in this video, we're going to talk about how the brain translates physical sensations into our everyday experiences. The primary way we experience the world is through the sense of vision. Vision is an incredibly complex phenomenon, and when you take a step back to consider it, it can almost seem like a superpower. When we see something, we're capturing depth, color, shape, and even motion all through the medium of light. Our eyes are able to detect light reflecting off an object, and our brains can then translate that information into an image. Visual sensory transduction, the process of converting light to electrical energy in our brains, occurs when light hits the retina and activates specific cells called photoreceptors. Photoreceptors convert light into neural impulses. These cells are separated into two distinct types, rods and cones. Rods are responsible for low-light black and white vision, whereas cones perceive different wavelengths of light, which provides the sensation of color. When light hits these cells, they release chemicals that are carried via the optic nerves to the sensory information transit center, the thalamus. From the thalamus, these signals then travel to the primary visual cortex, which is located in the occipital lobe. The primary visual cortex then projects this information to other parts of the brain. Similar concepts are used in the sense of hearing and touch. It's important to note that most sensory information will pass through the thalamus before going off to the part of the brain that deals with that particular sense. Think of the thalamus as a transit center, where sensory information is sorted and then sent to the correct location. Just like the eye specializes in vision, the ear specializes in audition or hearing. Sound waves, in the form of air vibrations, travel through the different ear structures to finally reach the cochlea, where changes of pressure caused by the sound waves are transduced into electrical signals. Normally, when you hear a sound, the vibrations travel from your eardrum through the oscillatory bones and into the organ of Corti, which is inside of the cochlea. You can think of the organ of Corti like a guitar string, with lots of sensory neurons placed all over it. If we imagine the cochlea is stretched out, we can see that sound frequencies resonate linearly. The brain then knows that auditory neurons stimulated near the base of the cochlea are high-pitched sounds, while those stimulated at the far end are low-pitch. These electrical signals are then sent through the thalamus to the auditory cortex in the temporal lobe. Auditory information is then translated into meaningful information, such as language, which is localized in the left hemisphere of the brain, or, more specifically, Wernicke's area. There are five basic tastes: sweet, sour, salty, bitter, and umami. The organ involved in taste detection is the tongue, which contains several types of taste buds. Each of these taste buds have about 50 to 100 taste cells. These cells, representing one or more of the five basic tastes, are activated by the food you're eating. These cells then convert the chemicals on your tongue into electrical signals. The signals then travel through the thalamus and into the gustatory cortex. The sense of smell is similar to taste, but instead of sending those signals to the gustatory cortex, information is instead sent to the olfactory bulbs in the frontal lobe for processing. The sensation of touch starts in the peripheral nervous system. This includes the detection of hot and cold, pressure, and proprioception, which is determining where your body is in space. The skin contains many nerve terminals, which connect to specific regions on the skin to provide the sensation of touch. The neurons in these regions are controlled by a pressure gate system. When pressure is applied to the skin, these specialized neurons then fire, providing the sensation of touch. These signals are then carried to the somatosensory cortex through two major pathways that pass through the spinal cord and connect within the primary somatosensory cortex. Through years of clinical and experimental research, neuroscientists have been able to create an accurate map of sensation in the brain. Real estate on this map is distorted to represent the number of sensory neurons in an area, irrespective of the size of that body part. Areas of the body with more sensory nerves have a larger representation within this area of the brain than those without as much sensitivity. To show this visually, the neurosurgeon Wilder Penfield commissioned the drawing of a human figure he called the homunculus, with grotesque proportions akin to that of a sensory map. He requested several revisions before he was happy with his terrifying but informative creation. People experience the world by combining different sensations simultaneously. Correlating senses helps us better understand the world around us. For example, you may smell fresh-cut grass as you walk through the park, with the sensation of your feet hitting the pavement, the bright sun casting shadows through the treetops, and the sound of children playing nearby. In order to engage fully with this experience and interact with the objects around us, we need to be able to process and draw conclusions from multiple senses simultaneously. Recent research suggests that sensory integration across multiple senses occurs primarily in the parietal lobe. However, exactly how this information is integrated into our internal view of the world is still very much a mystery. Despite this, current brain-computer interfaces are actually able to replicate certain senses in order to replace sensory organs that may have failed. The senses of touch, smell, hearing, and even sight have all been replicated with stimulatory brain-computer interfaces. Gaining a deeper understanding of how the brain works is one of the many goals of neurotechnology. Its continued advancement may eradicate blindness or hearing loss. The most common example of this is the cochlear implant, which allows the deaf and hard of hearing to perceive sound. Through better understanding of these areas, it may even be possible to add new senses. Someday, it may be possible to see wavelengths of light that are currently invisible to the naked eye. Through this video, we have developed a basic understanding of how sensory information is transmitted to the brain. We learned how the brain takes in information from the outside world in the form of our senses. We covered some areas of the brain that are responsible for processing sensory information, and talked about the underlying mechanisms that make this possible. The next video will cover motor processes.